Yan, so we have our first problem. Given the two forces daw, P1 and P2, compute the resultant of the forces. So, itong problem na to, this involves a 3D system. Kasi diba, yung F1 acts from this point up to here. And then yung F2 naman acts from this point up to here. Yan. So we have to resolve F1 and F2 into components. Now again, we have different methods for this problem. Merong vector na method, but ako, mas gusto ko yung component na method. So, lagay natin F1 saka F2. Yan. F pala yung label dito. Yan. So, for F1 and F2, lagay natin kung ano yung X, Y, and Z components niya. So, titingnan natin yung distance niya na na-travel along X, along Y, and along Z. So, F1 starts here, and then ito yung terminating point niya. So, from this point up to this point, the distance along X is, diba, 5 plus 3. So, that would give us 8. So, lagay natin 8. And then, for the distance naman along Y, ito yung Y-axis. Yan. So, from this point patungo dyan, ano yung distance along Y? So, check natin yung distance na parallel sa Y-axis. So, diba, from this point up to here, ito yung distance along Y, which is 2. So, lagay natin, along Y, we have 2. Then, ano naman along Z? Along Z, we started from here up to this edge. So, opposite ends, ano yung distance niya na parallel to the Z-axis? Diba, itong 3. Or simply, yan. Kasi this is 3 meters. Yan, according sa given natin. So, lagay natin dito, 3. And then, let's make another column para sa length. Yan. So, solve natin yan mamaya. And then, for F2 naman, check natin yung distance niya along X. So, nag-start siya dito, and then dito siya nag-end. So, yung distance niya na na-travel along X would be yung distance na yan. Simply, 5, itong buong distance, minus 2. Yan yung remaining distance dito. Yan. So, 5 minus 2, that would give us 3. Yan. Again, this comes from 5 minus 2, para ma-recall nyo. And then, along Y naman, along Y, we have from this point, patungo dyan, full distance na 4 meters. 2 plus 2. Yan. So, lagay natin 4. And then, along Z naman, still 3. Kasi diba, nasa opposite edges yan. Ito, nasa edge na to, and then opposite nyan is ito. So, 3 meters pa rin yung distance niya along Z. Yan. So, paano kukunin yung L? Yung L, kukunin natin by taking the square root of the sum of the squares of the components. So, 8 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared. Then, ito naman, 3 squared plus 4 squared plus 3 squared. Yan. So, sum up natin yung values niya. 8 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared. We have square root of 77. And then, yung isa naman, palitan na lang natin. 3, 4, saka 3. We have square root of 34. Now, since meron na tayong length, meron na din tayong components, again, magagamit natin yung components saka the total length to get the forces along X, along Y, and along Z. So, first, we can sum up forces along the X-axis. So, hindi magmamatter yung solution mo dito, dito, if meron kang assumption sa positive direction saka negative direction. So, along the x-axis, ito na lang yung positive direction ko. And then, along the z-axis, yung pa-forward yung positive direction ko. So, this one. And then, along the y-axis, ito naman yung positive direction ko. Yan. So, any force na going opposite to this, magiging negative na yan. So, summing up forces along x, F1 points toward the right. Diba? So, we have to use plus. So, gagawin natin, we have the force F1, this is 200, diba? 200 newtons. And then, F2 naman is 150 newtons. So, we have here 200 newtons, and then, ito yung gusto kong method, kasi pwede kong ma-pair yung x component sa length. Kung gusto kong mag-sum up ng forces along x. So, for the x component, I have 8. So, i-divide ko yan sa square root of 77 para makuha ko yung component along x. Ayan. And then, for F2, its component along x is pointing toward the left. Diba? Kasi, dyan siya nagpo-point. Meaning, we have to use minus. So, minus 150. Then, ano yung component ng F2 along x? Diba? 3. So, 3 divided by the length of F2. So, square root of 34. Ayan. So, pag isum up natin to, 200 times 8 over square root of 77, then minus 150 times 3 over square root of 34, this is 105.16. Ayan. And then, naka-newtons yan. So, pwede ko yung i-store. Store ko na lang yan sa letter A. Lagay ko na lang dito. Yan. And then, summation naman tayo ng forces along the y-axis. So, along y, lahat ng forces, excuse me, lahat ng forces natin are pointing downward. So, we have to use minus. So, minus 200, component ng F1 along y is 2. Diba? So, 2 divided by square root of 77. Then, for F2 naman, still minus. Component of F2 along y is 4. So, 4, divide natin yan by the length. So, square root of 34. Then, equal yan to input natin. Press up lang para let's just modify this one. So, negative 200 times eto, magiging 2. Then, this is already 4. So, negative 148.48. Yan. And then, this is newtons. So, store ko naman to sa letter B. Yan. And then, summation naman tayo ng forces along the z-axis. So, along the z-axis, lahat ng components ng forces natin are pointing toward the positive direction. Kasi diba, positive direction ko is pa-forward. Lahat ng forces natin pa-forward. Kasi pag i-draw natin yung z component niya, ito yan. Ito yung z component ng F1. And then for F2 naman, ito yung z component niya. So lahat pointing to the positive direction. Therefore, we have to use plus. Wait lang, yan. So, 200 times component ng F1 along Z is 3. So, 3 divided by square root of 77. Yan. And then, plus 150 times 3 divided by square root of 34. Ayan. Again, kung nagkamali ka sa, I mean, not nagkamali, kung if ever ito yung positive direction mo for the z-axis yung pa ganyan, And then, ito yung negative direction mo. Hindi yan magmamatter. As long as, naset mo lang kung ano yung positive direction mo or negative direction. So, this is equal to shift store. Nalagay ko na yan sa B. So, press up again. Yan. And then, modify na lang natin to. So, this is now positive. Then, ito magiging 3. Positive din to. Then, this is also 3. Yan. So, 145.55. Yan. So, isustore ko to sa letter C. Therefore, my resultant force is going to be square root of fx squared, summation of fx squared plus summation of fy squared plus summation of fz squared. Yan. Now, nakastore yan sa a, b, saka c. So, yung pag-input ko sa calculator would be shift store, lagay ko sa c. So, square root of a squared plus b squared plus c squared. Yan. So, press equals, we have 233.01. Ayan. Ito yung resultant force. Yan. So, pwede nyo i-check sa answer key natin, nakapost dito sa FB.